हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आर टुडेज टॉपिक इज वाटर ऑफ क्लास थर्ड। सो फॉर्म्स ऑफ वाटर इज, वाटर कैन बी फाउंड इन थ्री फॉर्म्स: सॉलिड, लिक्विड एंड गैस, विच इज ईजिली विजिबल इन योर सराउंडिंग एज यू आर हैविंग आइस, विच इज द सॉलिड फॉर्म ऑफ वाटर। लिक्विड फॉर्म इज वाटर विच वी यूज टू ड्रिंक, एंड द गैसियस फॉर्म इज वाटर वेपर्स। So this is the three form: liquid water, this is your solid ice, and this is your gas, which you can see this is the water vapors, the vapors which are formed due to the water, which is in gaseous form. So now the liquid water is, it is found in many places like tap water, raindrops, ponds, rivers, lakes, oceans. In all these things we are having the water in a liquid form. Pure liquid water is free of salt. There isn't any salt, rocks, soils and garbage in that. That would be the purest form of the water which we use for our drinking purpose. Solid water is ice, snow and frost. This is the form of the solid water. Ice, which you can see at your home very easily. Snow, we can see that in movies or in pictures, which are at the cold places. The Celsius is a scale to measure the temperature, as we can measure the weight in kilograms, the quantity like volume in liters. So similarly, if you want to measure the temperature, that would be in the Celsius. Like I can say 18 degrees Celsius, today's temperature is 40 degrees Celsius. So Celsius is used for measuring the temperature. Liquid water freezes at 0 degrees Celsius. If you want to freeze the liquid water, then it freezes at 0 degrees Celsius. Freezing is the process to freeze or to convert the liquid form into the solid form. Like I want to freeze ice cream, it is in the kind of liquid form or the viscous form, which I convert into the solid form. So I just use the word freeze over there. Like the process by which liquid water changes into solid is called freezing. If you want to change the liquid form into the solid one, so that process is known as freezing. Like ice cubes, ice on the skating rink, this is your freezed form of the water. Okay, so if you want to convert the liquid form into the freezing, into the solid form, that is via freezing. So now our third topic or the third form is gas, which you can say is water vapors. Water is a gas, is called a water vapors. You can see the water vapors in the form of steam when you are cooking something in pressure cooker. So when it whistles, the steam is coming out of that. So that is the example of a water vapor. Or you can take the example of a cup of tea, the hot cup of tea. Vapors are coming out of that in the form of steam. So water in the liquid state changes into water in the gaseous state. So this is your water vapor. So now evaporation is the water evaporates with the help of heat. If you want to evaporate anything, then you need required heat for that. Either the heat of sun, or you can give the temperature to it. Water evaporates to turn into a gas. The process of changes the water into water vapor is called your evaporation. Like I have taken some wet clothes and I just put it on the string to get it dry. After some time you can notice that the water which was into the clothes just went off and it's just evaporated due to the heat of that sun. Or naturally it can take much more time if there is no sun heat, and if you are drying it into a normal place or in a room, it will take much time as compared to that of the sun. But the water is evaporating from the wet clothes and you will get the dry clothes after it. So the next process is condensation. This is the process when you are converting water vapors into the liquid or into water on cooling. So that is known as your condensation. This is a very important step of water cycle. We will discuss it further. Now we are having water cycle, which I was talking about. So water of seas, river and ponds evaporate by the sun heat. This is the heat which is provided by the sun, cause of which the water of the sea, the rivers just start rising up and it start evaporating. It rises into air and forms clouds. When the water vapor just rises up, it just start forming clouds Okay, now the water vapor condense into the liquid water. It start condensing when it gets cooled up. On cooling, it start condensing and liquid water droplets falls down from the sky as rain. When it's just cooled up, it's get heavy and the cloud starts raining and you get that water again into the form of liquid. So rainwater collects in seas, rivers and ponds. So this is whole what is water cycle. So now this is the water cycle, as you can see. Okay, so this is the river where the water is collected. As you will get the heat from the sun, this water gets starting evaporated. So it is evaporating in the form of the water vapors, and as it is evaporating, after getting collected, it will form into the cloud. After that, on cooling, this heavy clouds will start raining and you will again get that water vapors into the form of liquid as rain. So this is the whole water cycle. So now we are the next topic is transpiration. When plants give out water vapors, that is called transpiration. The water is evaporating or that's getting out of that leaf. From that leaf, there are small pores present on the leaf through which that water just gets out. So that process by which the water from the plant is getting out is known as transpiration. Underground water. Some of the rainwater gets inside the earth is called underground water. The water which is stored inside the earth is known as your underground water. So water treatment. This is the treatment which is very much required nowadays. So water collected from the different sources is brought to the water treatment plant and then treated here with the chemicals. Okay. This treated water supplied to our homes through pipes. It should be stored in a clean and covered container. This is your water treatment plant. So like this is the river from where we are getting water. The sources are the places or the things from where we are getting that. So river is the source of water. From where I'm getting the water, this water is coming into this. This is your cleaning area where the water is get cleaned and further it is stored into that tank. This is the tank from where the water is supplied to the different houses and different places. So this clean water is get stored into that tank and later on supplied to our houses and our homes. So water pollution. All the activities make the water unfit for drinking is called water pollution. Causes of water pollution is what humans do is we humans do wash our clothes in their rivers, bath in the rivers. These are few activities and there are many more by which the water gets polluted or unfit for us to drink. Like throwing garbage into the rivers, dump harmful substances into the river which makes the water unfit. Water pollution is very harmful. By drinking polluted water, we can get diseases like cholera, jaundice and typhoid. These are few diseases which we actually get through the polluted water. Many aquatic plants and animals die because of polluted water. Aquatic plants and animals are those animals or plants which lives inside the water. Like fishes are the aquatic animals. So these are also getting polluted by the pollution of water. Conservation of water is if you want to save water, you want to conserve it, then that is known as conservation of water. Use only as much as water is required. Do not waste water. Do not pollute it, since the water is very much required in our day-to-day life. So just keep that clean. Close the tap well after use. When you are done with your regular activities, your daily activities, just keep your water tap closed. While brushing your teeth, do not leave the tap running. Open it when you require it. Just open your taps or keep this thing in your mind just to keep the water tap closed always. See that there are no leaking taps. Call a plumber and get them fixed. If any of your tap is getting leaked at your home, just call your plumbers and get it fixed on time. Using a washing machine that does not consume too much water to wash. Use your washing machines to clean your clothes. Now use a bucket and a mug to have a bath instead of a shower. If you want to save water, just use mug and a bucket. Water in which the vegetables and the fruits have been washed can be used to water the potted plants. If you want to say water, there are many more ways. If you are washing your vegetables, your fruits in some water, you instead of throwing that out into the your wash basin, just use that in your plants, just to water your plants instead of just throwing that out. At the end of the day, if you have water left in your water bottle, do not throw it away, but pour it into some plants. If you are having left some water into your bottles, water bottles, if you are getting back home from your offices, from your schools, so just do not throw it. Use to water that same, you can use that water to water the plant. Now, rainwater harvesting, how to conserve rainwater, how we can use that. This is the way to solve the problem of water shortage. We can collect the rainwater and use it later. If you want to store that water, this is a very good technique to save water. We can actually store that rainwater into some tank. That is known as rainwater harvesting. If you are saving on conserving the rainwater, that is rainwater harvesting. We can collect the rainwater and use it later. You can collect that water. This method is called rainwater harvesting. So this is rainwater harvesting. Like, this is our house. This is the terrace of our house. As this water is get collecting onto the terrace, we have connected a pipe over here from which we have dug a pit over here in which this whole water is getting collected. And you can use this water in many ways. Like, you can water your plants or whatever manner you want to. So this is just the way to harvest your water and to save water. Now, as we have seen our picture, that a pit is dug into the courtyard, rainwater collected on the roof of the house flows through the pipes into the pit of that we have constructed in front of our houses. Now, as we are done with our topic, which is water, as I have told you that water is very precious for us and it is very useful. So just do not waste your water and just take an oath for me that we won't waste our water anyhow, and we will follow all the things that I have told you in these slides and lectures that we won't use. And there are many ways that I have told you, so just keep that thing in your mind and just aware all those people who are around you and ask them not to waste water, as it is very precious for us.